In this problem, we're asked to evaluate dy dx if y equals x to the power 4 over 4 times the natural log of x, and all of that, minus x to the power 4 over 16. So the first element here, x to the power 4 over 4 times natural log of x, there we'll have to use the product rule. So let's just evaluate that part separately first. Let's just say that then let's just call it a equals x to the power 4 times a quarter, let's write it like that, times the natural log of x. So here we have the f of x equals a quarter x to the power 4, and our g of x is going to be natural log of x. If we get f prime of x, that is going to be x to the power 3, and the g prime of x is going to be 1 over x. So for this part, we can apply the chain rule, which is going to say that a prime is then going to be the f of x times the g prime of x plus the f prime of x g of x. If we evaluate that, f of x is a quarter x to the power 4, g prime of x is 1 over x, plus f prime of x is x to the power 3, and g of x is natural log of x. If we simplify this a bit, we're going to get, there we will get a quarter x to the power 3, plus here we're going to get x to the power 3 natural log of x. Now we also have to evaluate b. B is just going to be 1 16th x to the power 4. If we get b prime, that is going to be a quarter x to the power 3. Now y prime is just going to now be a prime minus b prime, and we can already see that that'll be a quarter x to the power 3 plus x to the power 3 natural log of x minus a quarter x to the power 3. These two will cancel out, so y prime, or in other words dy dx, is going to be x to the power 3 natural log of x. Quite a simple combination of the product rule, and just the derivative then of the natural log of x, which is 1 over x. Let's look at this problem. Y equals the natural log of x over x, and we are asked to evaluate dy dx. Now we can use the quotient rule here. Let's do that so that we might later do some more complicated problems with a quotient rule. The quotient rule stated that y prime, if the f of x was natural log of x and then g of x was x, was going to be the g of x times the f prime of x minus g prime of x, f of x, all divided by the g of x squared. The g of x all squared. So let us do that. What is the f of x in our example here? Well, that's the natural log of x, and g of x is going to be x. F prime of x is thus going to be 1 over x, and g prime of x is going to be 1. So y prime was going to be, what is the g of x? Well, that's x. What is f prime of x? That is 1 over x. Minus, what is g prime of x? That's 1. What is f of x? That's the natural log of x. And all of that over g of x squared, and g of x was x, and so that is x squared. So y prime is going to be, that cancels out, so that's just 1. So that's 1 minus the natural log of x over x squared. Let's go to the next problem. Here we have y equals the natural log of the natural log of x. Let's see what we can do here. We asked to evaluate, obviously, dy dx. Let us start, let's say y equals the natural log of u, with u being the natural log of x. Now we know that the chain rule states that dy dx is going to be dy du times du dx. If we substitute, that'll be the du of y, and y is the natural log of u, times the d dx, and u is the natural log of x. So that was going to be 1 over u times 1 over x. And u was natural log of x, so that's 1 over the natural log of x times 1 over x, and that equals 1 over x times the natural log of x. Quite easy in the end. Here is another potential problem for the quotient rule. So let us have our f of x be the natural log of x, and our g of x will thus be 1 plus the natural log of x. F prime of x would thus be 1 over x, and likewise g prime of x is also going to be just 1 over x, because the first derivative of 1, which is x to the power 0, is just 0. Now for our quotient rule, we're going to have that y prime equals the g of x, f prime of x, minus the f of x, g prime of x, all over g squared of x. G squared of x, if one can write it in that fashion indeed. So that is going to be, what is g of x? That's 1 over x. What is f? That's not g of x. G of x is 1 plus natural log of x. There we go. And what is f prime of x? Is 1 over x minus, what is f of x? Well, that's natural log of x. What is g prime of x? That's 1 over x. All divided by g of x squared. So that is 1 plus natural log of x all squared. So that leaves y prime being, if we multiply out, that'll be 1 over x. So that's this times that and this times that. So 1 over x plus natural log of x over x. If we multiply these two out, that is going to give us minus natural log of x over x. All of this over 1 plus natural log of x squared. If we give ourselves a bit more space, we'll notice that these two will cancel. That leaves us with 1 over x divided by, so we can just write that as 1 plus natural log of x squared. In the end, just making use of the quotient rule made this quite easy problem.